Okay, students, today we are going to learn about how to make a yes-no question. So for making a yes-no question, we have to know some basic thing. So that basic thing we are going to learn before we make a yes-no question, we have to know about some basic things. Okay, so first thing is, let's learn about them. We use auxiliary verbs are compulsorily used. It means if you do not know about the auxiliary verbs or if you don't recognize the auxiliary verb, then you feel problem to make a yes-no question. So to make a yes-no question, you should be very careful about the auxiliary verbs, or you should be sure about the auxiliary verb. Whenever you are sure about the auxiliary verb, then it is very easy for you to make yes no question. So as you know, or as you might have heard, there are 22 auxiliary verbs in English, and they are, now see here, is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, need to, used to, and dear. So these are the 24 auxiliary verbs. So they are used at the beginning of the sentence for making yes no question. And second thing is, yes no question starts with auxiliary. So each and every yes no question starts with auxiliary. We can't find any yes no questions which are not with the auxiliary verb. So each and every yes no question starts with auxiliary verb, the auxiliary verb as we mentioned earlier. Okay, and next thing we have to know is, this is question mark. Question mark is a must at the end of the sentence. So in each and every yes no question, we must use this question marks at the end of the sentence. Okay. And the fourth thing is the structure of yes no question. You should know what is the structure of yes no question. What things are included in the yes no question? What is exactly the shape of the yes no question? What is the structure of the yes no question? You should be very careful about that. As we discussed earlier, at the beginning of the sentence, there will be the auxiliary. That auxiliary means auxiliary verb, that out of the 24, like is, am, are, was, where, has, have, had, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, out to, need to, used to, dear, what, will, learn. And out of these 24, one will be here, and subject of the sentence and verb, and at last it will be the question marks. So this is the structure of the yes no question for affirmative or positive yes no question. For affirmative, or that is also called positive yes no question, and for negative yes no question, it is quite different. So auxiliary plus not will be also there, and subject and something will be there for the negative yes no question, maybe here verbs and something else. And similarly, negative yes no question might be in the another structure, that is auxiliary and subject and not, and then other thing may come here. So not can be used with auxiliary, or not can be used after subject as well. So generally we use the first one for the informal use and second one for the formal use. So they are for the negative yes no questions. Okay, then general rules for making a yes no question. So now we are going to learn some general rules for making a yes no question. What are the general rules that we are going to learn? And the first rule is, substitute your subject and auxiliary verb in the sentence. Okay, how easy it is. Okay, substitute your subject and auxiliary verb in the sentence. So in your sentence, you will find subject and you will also find your auxiliary verb. If it is the case, then you have to substitute it. See here, subject goes to auxiliary place And axillary comes to subject place. It's shown in the figure. Subject goes to axillary place and axillary goes to subject place. Let us see in the example. Ram has got a bus. So we see the sentence. Ram is a subject, has axillary. So Ram is a subject and has is an axillary. So as we have to make ask no question for that, and it becomes has Ram got a bus. So has gone to the Ram place and Ram has gone to the has place. So see here, Ram goes to the auxiliary place, has place, and has go to the here. In this way, this diagram will show you. So see here, subject and auxiliary has been substituted to each other. So this is the first rule we make ask a question, substituting auxiliary and subject. So this is the first rule. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule, that is the rule bivav in the sentence. If we have bivav in the sentence, we use the same bivav as auxiliary. So what is bivav? You might have been questioning sometime. So bivav is, am, are, was, where. These are bivavs. So these are auxiliary too, but whenever they function as the verb in the sentence, if is, am, are, was, where, these words come with another verb, then they will be auxiliary. But if they only appear in the sentence and another verb is missing, then in that case they will be called bivav. So like I am a student, am, this is the only am, and this is the verb. He is a teacher, only is there, and this is the verb. So is, am, are, was, where, mainly these words, these five words, so they are functioning as main verb, not as auxiliary. So that case we call bivav. In case of bivav, the same bivavs are used as auxiliary. Let us see in the example. He is a teacher. So is a bivav here, not an auxiliary, because it is functioning as the main verb. So the same is used here. Is he a teacher? Is he a teacher? We use in this way. Similarly, she was very tired. She was very tired. Was is the bivav here, main verb here, but it is a bivav. So we use the same was for the making ask no question. So was she very tired? Was she very tired? We bring was at the beginning. In the same way, they are students. They are students. So are is here as a bivav or the main verb, functioning as a main verb, but this is a bivav. So the same are is used here. Are they students? Are they students? So this is what, this is the second rule. The same bivav present in the sentence is used as auxiliary while making yes no question. Similarly, we can find here, we were sick, right? So were we sick? We were sick. This were has come at the beginning. So were we sick? In this way we make yes no question. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule, that is, if the sentence misses the auxiliary, if your sentence does not have auxiliary, then what to do, right? Sometimes we do not find auxiliary verb in the sentence, we do not even find bivav, we do not find auxiliary and bivav both. In that case, we have some problems. And one thing has been noted here, we must use verb 1 after do, does, did. Why it has been written here? Let us see here. At first, do for verb 1, and does, do, does, and did. These three auxiliary we use when our sentence is missing auxiliary. But after using this do, does, or did, we must use verb 1. That is a compulsory. So that we have to note it. So note has been given with here with the red marking. Okay, use do for verb 1. If your sentence does not have auxiliary verb, if your sentence misses auxiliary verb, and you have to see the what is the verb of your sentence. The auxiliary missing sentence has the verb with verb 1, or auxiliary missing sentence has verb with verb 2. That is what we call past, or the sentence that is missing auxiliary, that is verb 5 or that is verb singular. So what is the case? We have to see at first, then accordingly we have to use do, does, did. Auxiliary missing sentence as verb 1, then we use do. Similarly, if we use does for the verb 5, or that is singular verb, if it is singular verb, then we use verb 5 as an auxiliary. Similarly, we use did for the past verb, is, went, wanted, played, etc. If we find, then we use did. So see again, if we find like go, want, play, and no auxiliary, then this type of verb, plural verb, or that is what we call verb 1, then we use do as auxiliary. If we find goes, wants, plays, the verb with yes or yes, then we use verb 5 as an auxiliary. And if we finds past verb like went, wanted, played, sang, like that, then we use did as auxiliary. Okay, let us see some of the example for that. So we play chess. We see here, we play chess here. So play, verb 1 is here, verb singular is here, so that is why we use do we play chess. Similarly, she goes to market. So we see here, she goes to market. So goes is the verb 5, verb singular, that is why we use does. So does she go to market? So one thing we have to note is here, here is goes, but here is only go. In our earlier rule, we see there, we use only verb 1 or the verb plural after do, does, did. So here is do, play, verb 1, does, again go, this is verb 1. And again, we played football, another example, this is verb, past verb. So we use here did auxiliary, did we play football. See here, only play, not played, because we use verb 1 after did, do, and does. So this is the case. Okay. So we are in the rule number 4. In rule number 4, for the case of have verb, has, have, or had functioning as a main verb. Okay, so what is have verb? We should be very careful about that. So have, has, and had, when they come with verb 3, then they function as auxiliary. But if they appear independently in the sentence without verb 3 in the sentence, then this has, have, and had function as the main verb. In that case, we call them have verb. So in that case, have will be verb 1, has verb 5, and had verb 2, or have verb singular, has verb, so I'm very sorry, have verb plural, has verb singular, and had verb past. So the case is the same here. Have verb, that is verb 1, and auxiliary is do. And has verb, that is verb 5, and auxiliary is does. And had verb, that is verb 2, and auxiliary is did. Okay. So let us see here example. They had a bus. They had a bus. So we do not find here any other auxiliary. So this had is functioning as the main verb. So that is why this is a have verb. Past had have verb. So because of this is past, the verb too. So we are using here did. Did they have the bus? As we already know that after do, does, did, we often use verb 1. So the verb 1 form of had is have. So that is why did they have a bus. Similarly, he has a bus. He has a bus. This is verb 5, right? This is verb 5. Have verb, but function is verb 5. So does he have a bus? So does he have a bus is here. Let us see the case of have. We have a bus. Do we have a bus? This is verb 1. So we have used here do. So do we have a bus? In this way we can do. So we are going to learn the next rule, that is, sometime a sentence can have two helping verbs or two auxiliary verbs or helping verbs. If this is the case, change the order of the subject and first helping verb or auxiliary verb in the sentence in the same way, then after the subject put the second helping. So you can see here in the example, this is very simple. For example, John has been fired, right? John been fired, helping verb 1 plus subject plus helping verb 2 plus main verb. So what has been written here? John, and before main verb, you see here he has and also been. So you should not be confused. You have to use the first one as an auxiliary, not as the second one. Okay, so has, this is the first. So has John, and this second one should be put after subject. So John is the subject. So first put first auxiliary has, then subject, then the second helping verb you will use here. Has John been fired? So helping verb 1 at first, auxiliary, helping verb, auxiliary is also called helping verb, and then subject and helping verb 2 and main verb and other remaining things we use in this way. So they will be hired. So be and will, two things we find, but we use the first one, be, will. Similarly, the train is going to arrive, so we also see going to and is, but we use the is the train going to and arrive. So in this way we do, this is the case. Similarly, we find other, the painter was being repaired, and he was the painter being repaired, right? In this way we can do. So this is the case. Now let us see another rule, that is some special rule for making yes no question we are going to learn. Okay, so first, change already, lately, recently into at. So this is the case. If your sentence has already, lately, or recently, you have to change it into YET8, and YET8 goes at the end of the sentence. So as you can see here, he has already finished his work, he has not finished his work yet, right? In place of, if you have even find lately, he has lately finished his work, he has not finished his work yet, and even if you have, he has recently finished his work, then again your answer is he has not finished his work yet. So already, lately, recently somehow give the similar type of the meaning. And the second rule, especially you are going to learn, is some change into any. So they have some money, right? It changes into they have. Do they have any money? So as we know, how do it come there? Have is the main verb here, so do comes here. Do they have some change into any money? Similarly, someone was waiting for you, it changes into was anyone waiting for you. Was, some change into any, right? One is one and waiting for you. And finally, next special rule is change a lot of into much or many, right? If you have a lot of in your sentence, then you have to change it into many or much. So if you find a lot of before countable, then it changes into many, and if you find a lot of before uncountable, then you have to change it into much. There are lots of mango. There are lots of mango. So mangoes, that is countable. So before countable, there is a lot of. So you have to change it into many. So are there many mangoes? Are there many mangoes? Lot of has changed into many. So there is a lot of water in the ground. So there is lot of water in the ground. So lot of is there. Lot of is there before water. So water is uncountable. So is there much water in the ground? So in this way we change. So lot of is changed into either many or much. Okay, now next rule we are going to learn is how to make yes no question for imperative. So that is yes no question for imperative, we add will you. We have to add will you before the sentence for making imperative sentence question. So let us see here, open the door. So it's yes no question is will you open the door. Similarly, don't go there. So negative we find, will you not go there? So don't go is there. So will you, we have added, and one did not we use because we do not use two auxiliary in a sentence. So will you not go there? Similarly, let him go. Will you let him go? And here is a question mark, right? Will you let him go? And similarly, let's go. Let us go. So will you let us go? Is here. Similarly, sentence with let's. If your sentence starts with let's, then we have to add shall we instead of will you, and that what we are going to see here, shall we go. And similarly, let's go change into shall we go. Similarly, let's swim change into oh shall we swim. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule. I think this is the last rule we are going to learn. I, my, me change into you or your. For example, I am a student, it change into are you a student. I change into you because you do not ask question yourself, you can ask question to the second person. So for, so generally this first person singular change into second person. Similarly, I have a pen. Do you have a pen? Okay, students, today we are going to learn about how to make yes no question. So for making yes no question, we have to know some basic thing. So that basic thing we are going to learn before we make yes no question, we have to know about some basic things. Okay, so first thing is let's learn about them. We use auxiliary verbs are compulsorily used. It means if you do not know about the auxiliary verbs or if you don't recognize the auxiliary verb, then you feel problem to make yes no question. So to make yes no question, you should be very careful about the auxiliary verbs, or you should be sure about the auxiliary verb. Whenever you are sure about the auxiliary verb, then it is very easy for you to make yes no question. So as you know, or as you might have heard, there are 22 auxiliary verbs in English, and they are, now see here, is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, need to, used to, and dear. So these are the 24 auxiliary verbs. So they are used at the beginning of the sentence for making yes no question. And second thing is yes no question starts with auxiliary. So each and every yes no question starts with auxiliary. We can't find any yes no questions which are not with the auxiliary verb. So each and every yes no question starts with auxiliary verb, the auxiliary verb as we mentioned earlier. Okay, and next thing we have to know is this is question mark. Question mark is a must at the end of the sentence. So in each and every yes no question, we must use this question marks at the end of the sentence. Okay, and the fourth thing is the structure of yes no question. You should know what is the structure of yes no question, what things are included in the yes no question, what is exactly the shape of the yes no question, what is the structure of the yes no question. You should be very careful about that. As we discussed earlier, at first, at the beginning of the sentence, there will be the auxiliary. That auxiliary means auxiliary verb, that out of the 24, like is, am, are, was, where, has, have, had, shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might, must, out to, need to, used to, dear, what, will, learn. And out of these 24, one will be here, and subject of the sentence, and verb, and at last it will be the question marks. So this is the structure of the yes no question for affirmative or positive yes no question. For affirmative, or that is also called positive yes no question. And for negative yes no question, it is quite different. So auxiliary plus not will be also there, and subject and something will be there for the negative yes no question. Maybe here verbs and something else. And similarly, negative yes-no question might be in the another stage, that is auxiliary and subject and not, and then other thing may come here. So not can be used with auxiliary, or not can be used after subject as well. So generally we use the first one for the informal use and second one for the formal use. So they are for the negative yes-no questions. Okay, then general rules for making yes-no question. So now we are going to learn some general rules for making yes-no question. What are the general rules that we are going to learn? And the first rule is substitute your subject and auxiliary verb in the sentence. Okay, how easy it is. Okay, substitute your subject and auxiliary verb in the sentence. So in your sentence you will find subject and you will also find your auxiliary verb. If it is the case, then you have to substitute it. See here, subject goes to auxiliary place and auxiliary comes to subject place. It's shown in the figure. Subject goes to auxiliary place and auxiliary goes to subject place. Let us see in the example. Ram has got a bus. So we see the sentence. Ram is a subject, has auxiliary. So Ram is a subject and has is an auxiliary. So as we have to make yes-no question for that, and it becomes has Ram got a bus. So has gone to the Ram place and Ram has gone to the has place. So see here, Ram goes to the auxiliary place, has place, and has go to the here. In this way, this diagram will show you. So see here, subject and auxiliary has been substituted to each other. So this is the first rule we make yes-no question, substituting auxiliary and subject. So this is the first rule. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule, that is the rule be verb in the sentence. If we have be verb in the sentence, we use the same be verb as auxiliary. So what is be verb? You might have been questioning sometime. So be verb is, am, are, was, were. These are be verbs. So these are auxiliary to, but whenever they function as the verb in the sentence, if is, am, are, was, were, these words come with another verb, then they will be auxiliary. But if they only appear in the sentence and another verb is missing, then in that case they will be called be verb. So like I am a student, am, this is the only am and this is the verb. He is a teacher, only is there and this is the verb. So is, am, are, was, were, mainly these words, these five words, so they are functioning as main verb, not as auxiliary. So that case we call be verb. In case of be verb, the same be verbs are used as auxiliary. Let us see in the example. He is a teacher. So is a be verb here, not an auxiliary, because it is functioning as the main verb. So the same is used here. Is he a teacher? Is he a teacher? We use in this way. Similarly, she was very tired. She was very tired. Was is the be verb here, main verb here, but it is a be verb. So we use the same was for the making yes-no question. So was she very tired? Was she very tired? We bring was at the beginning. And in the same way, they are students. They are students. So are is here as a be verb or the main verb, functioning as a main verb, but this is a be verb. So the same are is used here. Are they students? Are they students? So this is what, this is the second rule. The same be verb present in the sentence is used as auxiliary while making yes-no question. Similarly, we can find here, we were sick, right? So were we sick? We were sick. This were has come at the beginning. So were we sick? In this way, we make Yes, no question. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule. That is, if the sentence misses the auxiliary, if your sentence does not have auxiliary, then what to do? Right? Sometimes we do not find auxiliary verb in the sentence. We do not even find be verb. We do not find auxiliary and be verb both. In that case, we have to we have some problems. And one thing has been noted here: we must use verb 1 after do, does, did. Why it has been written here? Let us see here. At first, do for verb 1, and does, do, does, and did. These three auxiliary we use when our sentence is missing auxiliary. But after using this do, does, or did, we must use verb 1. That is a compulsory. So that we have to note it. So note has been given with here with the red marking. Okay, use do for verb 1. If your sentence does not have an auxiliary verb, if your sentence misses auxiliary verb, and you have to see the what is the verb of your sentence. The auxiliary missing sentence has the verb with verb 1, or auxiliary missing sentence has verb with verb 2. That is what we call past, or the sentence that is missing auxiliary, that is verb 5 or that is verb singular. So what is the case? We have to see at first, then accordingly we have to use do, does, did. Auxiliary missing sentence as verb 1, then we use do. Similarly, if we use does for the verb 5, or that is singular verb, if it is singular verb, then we use verb 5 as an auxiliary. Similarly, we use did for the past verb, is, went, wanted, played, etc. If we find, then we use did. So see again, if we find like go, want, play, and no auxiliary, then this type of verb, plural verb, or that is what we call verb 1, then we use do as auxiliary. If we find goes, wants, plays, the verb with yes or yes, then we use verb 5 as an auxiliary. And if we finds past verb like went, wanted, played, sang, like that, then we use did as auxiliary. Okay, let us see some of the example for that. So we play chess. We see here we play chess here. So play, verb 1 is here, verb singular is here. So that is why we use do we play chess. Similarly, she goes to market. So we see here she goes to market. So goes is the verb 5, verb singular. That is why we use does. So does she go to market? So one thing we have to note is here. Here is goes, but here is only go. In our earlier rule, we see there we use only verb 1 or the verb plural after do, does, did. So here is do, play, verb 1, does, again go. This is verb 1. And again, we played football, another example. This is verb, past verb. So we use here did auxiliary. Did we play football? See here, only play, not played, because we use verb 1 after did, do, and does. So this is the case. Okay. So we are in the rule number 4. In rule number 4, for the case of have verb, has, have, or had functioning as a main verb. Okay, so what is have verb? We should be very careful about that. So have, has, and had, when they come with verb 3, then they function as auxiliary. But if they appear independently in the sentence without verb 3 in the sentence, then this has, have, and had function as the main verb. In that case, we call them have verb. So in that case, have will be verb 1, has verb 5, and had verb 2, or have verb singular, has verb, so I'm very sorry, have verb plural, has verb singular, and had verb past. So the case is the same here. Have verb, that is verb 1, and auxiliary is do, and has verb, that is verb 5, and auxiliary is does, and had verb, that is verb 2, and auxiliary is did. Okay. So let us see here example. They had a bus. They had a bus. So we do not find here any other auxiliary. So this had is functioning as the main verb. So that is why this is a have verb. Past had have verb. So because of this is past the verb too. So we are using here did. Did they have the bus? As we already know that after do, does, did, we often use verb 1. So the verb 1 form of had is have. So that is why did they have a bus. Similarly, he has a bus. He has a bus. This is verb 5, right? This is verb 5. Have verb, but function is verb 5. So does he has a bus? Does he have a bus? So does he have a bus is here. Let us see the case of have. We have a bus. Do we have a bus? This is verb 1. So we have used here do. So do we have a bus? This way we can do. So we are going to learn the next rule, that is sometime a sentence can have two helping verbs or two helping verbs or two auxiliary verbs or helping verbs. If this is the case, change the order of the subject and first helping verb or auxiliary verb in the sentence in the same way, then after the subject put the second helping. So you can see here in the example, this is very simple. For example, John has been fired, right? John been fired. Helping verb 1 plus subject plus helping verb 2 plus main verb. So what has been written here? John and before main verb, you see here he has and also been. So you should not be confused. You have to use the first one as an auxiliary, not as the second one. Okay, so has, this is the first. So has John, and this second one should be put after subject. So John is the subject. So first put first auxiliary has, then subject, then the second helping verb you will use here. Has John been fired? So helping verb 1. At first auxiliary helping verb, auxiliary is also called helping verb, and then subject and helping verb 2 and main verb and other remaining things we use in this way. So they will be hired. So be and will, two things we find, but we use the first one, be, will. Similarly, the train is going to arrive, so we also see going to and is, but we use the is the train going to and arrive. So in this way we do, this is the case. Similarly, we find other, the painter was being repaired, and he was the painter being repaired, right? In this way we can do. So this is the case. Now let us see another rule, that is some special rule for making yes no question we are going to learn. Okay, so first change already lately recently into at. So this is the case. If your sentence has already lately or recently, you have to change it into yet, and yet goes at the end of the sentence. So as you can see here, he has already finished his work, he has not finished his work yet, right? In place of, if you have even find lately, he has lately finished his work, he has not finished his work yet. And even if you have, he has recently finished his work, then again your answer is he has not finished his work yet. So already, lately, recently somehow give the similar type of the meaning. And the second rule, especially you are going to learn, is some change into any. So they have some money, right? It changes into they have. Do they have any money? So as we know how do it come there, have is the main verb here, so do comes here. Do they have some change into any money? Similarly, someone was waiting for you, it changes into was anyone waiting for you. Was some change into any, right? One is one and waiting for you. And finally, next special rule is change a lot of into much or many, right? If you have a lot of in your sentence, then you have to change it into many or much. So if you find a lot of before countable, then it changes into many. And if you find a lot of people uncountable, then you have to change it into moss. There are lots of mango. So mangoes that is countable. So before countable, there is a lot of. So you have to change it into many. So are there many mangoes? Lot of has changed into many. So there is a lot of water in the ground. So lot of is there before water. So water is uncountable. So is there much water in the ground? So in this way we change. So a lot of is changed into either many or much. Okay, now next rule we are going to learn is how to make yes no question for imperative. So that is yes no question for imperative. We add will you. We have to add will you before the sentence for making imperative sentence question. So let us see here. Open the door. So it's yes no question is will you open the door. Similarly, don't go there. So negative we find will you not go there. So don't go is there. So will you we have added, and only not we use because we do not use two auxiliary in a sentence. So will you not go there. Similarly, let him go. Will you let him go? And here is a question mark, right? Will you let him go? And similarly, let's go. Let us go. So will you let us go is here. Similarly, sentence with let's. If your sentence starts with let's, then we have to add shall we instead of will you, and that what we are going to see here. Shall we go? And similarly, let's go change into shall we go. Similarly, let's swim change into how shall we swim. Okay, now we are going to learn another rule. I think this is the last rule we are going to learn. I, my, me change into you or your. For example, I am a student, it change into are you a student. I change into you because you do not ask question yourself, you can ask question to the second person. So for, so generally this first person singular change into second person. Similarly, I have a pen. So do you have a pen?